Hi, I'm Big Dom, and welcome to part 6 of my walkthrough for Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice. Last time we left off, we had completed the 4 trials, and now we're going to go and get the blue sword. So from where we are, we have to walk all the way around, I think, yeah. Walk all the way around the outside of the tree. Get back up to the front of the tree where the blue light is. Okay.
Dillian gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind and become a warrior in Dillian's clan.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
But years later.
Oh, that's not good.
With Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. The plague.
Dillian?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
Dillian?
Do you see it clearly now, Senua? The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
Oh, well, this looks another nice inviting place. It looks like you need to use heavy strikes here.
There's nowhere to run to.
In the sea of corpses, the corpse waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from a land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred.
This reminds me of the film Labyrinth with all the hands. When the girl falls down the hole.
Come not with disturbed mind.
Reminds me of the Helping Hands, yeah.
Suffering, Senua. Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you banned the curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinbel, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
Thank you. So you got to use focus to make them appear by the looks of it. Ah. Once again, I really don't like these shield warriors.
Who is it? Galena?
Where are you?
Do you hear, Senua? Do you hear the voice of your mother, Galena? She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Help me.
Doubted the gods and let the darkness infest her. But she didn't run. She escaped the...
So it looks like I'm in a pool of blood.
She gave her life to the gods.
Just when you think this game couldn't get any worse for her, and it just does.
The world would have been spared this horror. It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Oh. Okay. That one didn't go too well. That guy's very quick. Jesus. Oh! I can't even get... Jesus. Oh! I think I'm going to take this, just keep dodging until I get an opening. Ah, see, you can't even... Jesus! Okay, let's try it. Okay, that doesn't get blocked. Yeah, it looks like... Well, you can't block the kick, though. Oh! Jesus. Now, do I have to go and fight that big guy? Yes, oh Christ. Jesus Christ, how many of these things are there? Thank you. There's a lot of enemies in this bit. Oh no, don't die there, don't die there. Oh Christ, no, 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 oh. Oh, please don't tell me I have to go back to the beginning. Am I actually going the right way? See, it turns you round. When you come back alive, it turns you round. So you kind of get confused which way you're going. I think I'm going this way.
Why do you still fight on? Maybe you two should suffer with your brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas and the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around you. Hope is there for even if a soul could be rescued. Do you think he thanked you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
Where am I heading to now?
You're both dead. You both surrendered to the voices. The darkness has taken you. Galena and Senua. Galena and Senua.
Once again, you think that this game can't get any worse in the scenery, and it just does. And so I'm now crossing dead bodies. That took a little bit longer than expected.
I can't fight it anymore. Not on my own.
So I've escaped the sea of corpses.
I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Don't let this darkness come between us.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender.
She's beginning to look quite scary now.
All she needed was a little...
With her eyes and...
A little hope.
Okay, so I presume we're going this way. Leaving the tree behind. So it looks like we're heading back to the big door that was in the beginning of this area. Assume this will be going to Helheim.
We found her. We found you. We thought we lost. Where have you been?
Here she is.
Don't worry.
So we're here to help you.
You don't have to do this on your own anymore.
You need us.
There's a way in.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up
she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain? She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she?
Look up.
So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did. She did.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
So we've entered Helheim now. Lorestone straight there.
I will tell you of a great hero.
Looks like I've missed two runestones now.
Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rayan. But Rayan does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rayan's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rayan's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself.
Can't go that way.
Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark.
You can drop down this way.
A dragon.
Well, that doesn't sound good.
A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Okay, so if you get in the light, it looks like you can't. After that's barred.
To do. Your father wants them to go away, and he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't
listen. Do you
to them.
See them? Do you see their faces?
Okay, so it's a rune door.
She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. doesn't matter now, does it?
Okay. I think I'm going to like these places. Can't see myself here. Okay, so if I'm lighting the torches, okay, so this must be one of the runes here. Ah, there we go. Assume we head back up. Okay, not quite sure where I need to go here. That's a pit. Oh, hey, Carl. try this way.
Her torch is going out. No, it's not. Get everyone else. She hasn't got much time. She's too slow. It's not going to burn out. The darkness will come again.
Reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. That's what children say all the time.
Okay.
That there are monsters.
Let's check back downstairs. Right, I'm going to go back this way.
That only she could see them.
Usually when you open doors, you have to go back the other way. I've kind of found in this game. Ooh, don't want to fall down the stairs. Down this time.
The beast has been here. Everywhere. Must be from here. She has to keep going.
No, I bet I'm going to lose my torch here. Some light in front of me, so I'm presuming I'll need to get there. Okay, let's go to the next bit. Some fire. Okay. And get some. Ah, thank God for that. I got some light back. So now I can light the torches. Are there any torches around here? Okay. That's one. I'm just going to carry on following the path to light these torches by the looks of it. Oh, hold on. There you go.
Do you feel it? The beast is crawling into your mind, searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
Ah, there's a lore stone here.
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a sword for him.
I would assume now we're going to try to head up that his father once left.
A sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rain go in search of Fafnir.
Oh, and there's a lore stone in here.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of him.
Oh, we're back at the rune door now, so we can head through that.
Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
It's a trap.
Oh god, I've lost my light. Think I'm gonna have to run. Yeah, I'm gonna have to run. This is
now
one of the most disturbing games I've ever played, I think.
The time you suffered as a child at the hands of your father Zimbo while you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Did you leave me? This darkness, it's spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others, away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillion.
Okay. So we've regained control again.
Thank you.
I'm kind of getting scared once I go into the dark again, because I haven't got no torch now, and usually when I'm heading into a dark area, it's something's going to come and chase me. Okay, right, we've got a torch now.
The beast is down there. No.
She knows the beast is down. He's always
watching you.
You can feel him. She needs to find it.
She lost it and she has to fight it.
I'm heading further and further down. Oh, there looks like there's a rune door there. Oh, okay.
Behind you.
They're coming up. You're in a very small behind space here. Oh, no, no, no. There's a lot. I hope there's not a lot of these. Okay. I'm not going to forget my torch, actually, at the end of the day. Okay. So it looks like we can only go this way. Okay. So it looks like it's going to shine through here. There we go. Lighting the torch has made it appear in an R with the wooden planks on the other side. So now I can go and open this door. Okay, this is going to douse my torch.
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
There's a lore stone there and a rune door.
The beast has the head.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak. And they say, Sigurd should have the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell.
So that looks like an end.
Find Grimhild, the Valkyrie.
If I light that... So this is new, so I'm going to head down here. Okay, so now that's lit. Okay, see there's a waterfall back there that I'm probably gonna have to run through.
Oh,
Now I've got to knock that bridge down by the looks of it.
Faster, faster, keep going, keep going. Stop! You can't get through, you have to do it. Get up, get up! What are you doing?
Okay. Ah, there we go. We have to light this final brazier. There you go. So now we can get through the door. This looks like the last lawstone in the chapter, so hopefully we're getting near to the end of it.
Separates us from what we fear.
Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless and passes through the flames just as I did, and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes. Namely, victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and help, runes for perception and power.
More creepy hands trying to grab me.
Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes to fight amongst the gods in hell.
Oh, Christ.
You're not taking it from me.
I warn you, Senua. I can smell your
blood. No!
You betrayed your god.
I am leaving with him.
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillian will rot in hell. Come into my shadow.
So I'm just dodging and... Oh god. Oh, Christ. This goes into darkness again. I don't even know if I'm going to try blocking here. Oh! Oh Christ! I think he's got me. Yep. So I need to keep dodging. Okay. I think I'm going to have to go back to trying to block here, because this isn't happening. This isn't working. Yeah, blocking's definitely the way to go. Okay. Oh. Oh, crap. Christ, that even blocking doesn't. Jesus. Getting good here. You just can't see. Just, I can't see. Going again. Jesus, this isn't happening.
Darkness.
Oh, so that one just cannot be blocked by the looks of it. No, that one just can't be blocked. This video is ending up being a lot longer. A lot longer than I thought. This part six. I just didn't even see where it came from. This is beginning to kind of get on my nerves now. Button. This is definitely not going well. Ugh. Come on. We can do this. It's just hard parrying with you can't see him. There you go. Thank you. Oh, finally. Thank God for that. Oh, maybe not. Well, that made me jump. Didn't expect him to come back.
People think of it as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection.
But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand. Cold and cruel.
He tried to fix her with his rituals. Kept her trapped in that hole.
She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness.
Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both.
Well, apologies that fight took so long. It's just, it gets very disorientating when it goes dark. You can't see where Fenrir is coming from.
If she had stayed.
Very hard to block.
She would have survived.
So it took a few tries to get through that. I'm glad that's done and finished.
Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore. But believe this, it was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it could focus your mind on this quest. Without it, I fear you would let failures slack. All this time, I hardly wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn.
And so I think we'll be moving into Hela's Sanctum next, by the looks of it.
I won't stand in your way. You will not survive what is in there.
Okay, so I'm going to call it a day there for part six. And when we come back, we'll be heading into Hela's Sanctum. Once again, thanks for watching. Sorry it took so long to get past that boss. Very, very awkward not being able to see, and very well in the actual battle itself. But yeah, thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and feel free to share with a friend if you think this will be helpful to someone else, and if you've enjoyed watching it. Thanks a lot. See you later.